next topic is for local maxima and local minima. Now exactly what it is, local maxima, and normally it is also called as a relative maxima or relative minima. Okay, so now let f be a real valued, let f be a real valued function and let C be an interior point, C be an interior point in the domain, in the domain of F. Then now in place of C we can use x0 also, but it will make something confusing. Okay, so C is okay, or if you wish you can take x0. Now interior point in the domain of F, then number one, two things we are going to discuss: local maxima, local minima. Okay, now number one, what is C is called a point of local maximum if there is an, now if there is an, what an? A value. If there is an, let me write here also, if there is an h greater than 0, h is a value which is greater than 0. C is called a point of local maxima if there is an h greater than 0 such that fc is greater than is equal to fx, as we have gone through the maximum and minimum values. Okay, but here a little bit change is there. There it was for all values of x belongs to real numbers. Now here what is, for all values of x in, now this is the most important thing, for all values of x in c minus h, c plus h. Okay, this is the most important thing. Now the value fc is called local maximum value of f. Now local maximum value is also termed as local maxima. Okay, the value fc is called the local maximum value of f. Is it clear? Now second part b, c is called a point of local, now it is minimum, okay, and we are adding local minima, if there is an h here also it is greater than 0, if there is a h, okay, if there is a h greater than 0 such that fc is less than is equal to fx for all x in, again c minus h and c plus h, and the value fc is called local minimum . Okay, so now we are going for the a little bit, don't confuse it. Okay, we are having a point C such that it is h is greater than 0, little bit less than C, more than C. Okay, So we are having local maxima and local minima.